tuning in today. So today's makeup look is going to be focused around this eye, this beautiful, gorgeous purple smoky. This is the look that I wore for my birthday. So since everyone was like, we didn't see you, we didn't see how you did the eye, I decided to film this eye makeup and just have fun and have a chit chat. But I hope you guys really enjoy this video. I tried all my best to make it a little bit shorter, not long, but you know, it is what it is. Okay guys, so this look, like I said, is quite easy, quite quick. I wanted to focus on the eye area. As you can see, I've already done the rest of my face. I've left it at baking, so it's going to be easier to clean my face after I've applied all my eyeshadow and eye products, right? Okay, so today I'm actually going to do a talk over. So just to catch up, guys, just to, you know, get in tune with everything, just to talk to you guys, just to tell you things. I don't have much to tell because I generally am at school all day and I haven't done any fun stuff lately. It was my birthday, however, I had so much fun. But we'll get to that while I'm actually doing the makeup, okay? Yeah, so I'm going to go in with my Paintly paint pot from MAC, and I'm gonna apply it with my finger just so that it's nicely done. Also, I'm just trying to be quick about it. I'm not trying to spend a lot of time. By the way, this paint pot is gonna help the color pay off. What? It's gonna help the color intensify. It's gonna intensify the color. What are you saying? You see, this is why I don't do talkovers and chit chats, because I have tongue twist. I'm gonna stop talking right now and continue with my makeup. Okay? Blend it well with your finger. It's quite easy. It's not like a brush where you're gonna have brush strokes and everything. Your finger just literally lays everything on point onto the eye. Quick and easy. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm indirectly blending with my finger as I do this, by the way. I mean, you guys can see, obviously. A sort of like a winged smoky. So yeah. So I actually think I should have asked or did like a get to know me question thing on Instagram, because I've been getting a lot of people asking me about who I am and what I do, and I kind of noticed that I haven't really done a get to know me tag. So I think I'm gonna do that on my next video and just answer a few questions about who I am, what I do, what inspires me, and why I am basically doing this. So please answer it, guys. Please answer the question so I can give the people what they want, because nobody in this lifetime. Also, I have a chat that's made up that. I'm gonna tell you this complaint I have, right? I have a complaint about people who suggest things to me, like, please do this, please do that, please do this for us, but y'all don't watch my videos. And that's why I'm failing to be consistent with my posting, because y'all don't watch a girl's videos. So guys, you can't be suggesting things and then not watching. You know, please watch my videos. Please subscribe and please follow. And please go to Instagram and follow and suggest things that I can do for you guys. Like, I'm just trying my best out here. It's tough. It's really difficult. Okay. So I'm going to apply the under eye area as well. so that it actually works. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in with my MAC self-made palette. Well, not self-made as in I constructed the whole thing. I just added these colors. I'm sure you guys have noticed what I use usually. And the color that I'm gonna go in is this color, which is an orange, and its name is Red Brick. I'm gonna apply it with a really thick brush, my concealer brush from Real Techniques, just because I want it to be really fluffy. And it's a transition color, so you wanna keep sort of like your skin warm. Brushing it off. Supposed to be born in this era. Like, I genuinely feel like my time should have been like in the 90s, 80s. Not because, I'm not saying this because I've been seeing a lot of this era go on trend right now. Everyone is doing the 90s, you know, the cool kid 90s and the 80s and whatnot. But I've been in love with the era. I've been in love with the fashion of the time. Just the vibe of it, but I feel like I've never been that cool kid to try something like that, you know, on myself. I mean, obviously my style is a bit mature and is a bit like vintage, especially when it comes to fashion and stuff like that. But I genuinely feel like I wasn't supposed to be born right now. Can you, I'm just in love with the fashion and the style and whatnot of the 1980s. Well, my favorite time was not the 70s. I felt like there was a point where trends shifted to the 1970s, which was a bit of a, like, it was a, sort of like a fad to me, because that didn't last a whole year. Like, it lasted for a time, but obviously being in South Africa, all these shops will jump on these trends super late, which now you're like, but we've been doing like this, and you know, but I'm really liking what's going on in, like, in fashion right now. It's sort of like super blurred. Everyone is doing their own thing, but at the same time you can see a direction, you can see where the inspiration comes from. Definitely a lot of 90s, definitely a lot of 80s coming through, especially on the runway. And I'm loving it. I'm loving where fashion is going right now, and I hope everyone experiments with, like, the clothing, because I'm not gonna lie, like, it's very fun. So that's why on my previous video I decided to do like a 90s vibe going on, and this look is just refreshing. It's for the summer, you know, and I've been highly influenced by this year. Moving along, I'm going to add a pink to my eye just to add on to my transition color, which is going to be, it's like a pink purplish color. So this color over here, also from my MAC palette. Let me check what the color's name is. Saucy Mist. It's a really, really beautiful color, and a nice pink plush citrus vibe to it. Okay, so I'm gonna put that directly where I put the orange as a transition color as well. Right over there, and I'm gonna pull it out different styles coming through, different eras being mixed and all of that. I'm definitely liking the Gulp Core or Gulp Cool, according to WGSA. I think that's the Gulp Cool. It's like workwear being highly fashionable. I think my opinion is, you know, I like the fact that sportswear and outerwear is being recognized as like a high fashion statement. I don't know if people will push it to that level though. I don't know if I can still call it like high fashion or put it in the same category as high fashion, and sort of like take away the street from, I mean, you won't take away the streets directly, but you sort of like, like you sort of like we welcoming it into like making it fashion. But also I feel like a selected few have done it and have done it well, depending on how well you dress it up and like, you know, style it and all that sort of thing. I feel like it's a trend that is very sustainable and a trend that's gonna last a very long time based on like what people are doing and showing like that individuality of how people are dressing. So I'm for it, hey? I'm for personal and self-experimentation when it comes to fashion. I like the fact that everyone is going the direction and the lines are pretty much like a little bit blurred, you know what I mean, to mainstream fashion or mainstream sportswear or street fashion. I don't know if you guys know what I mean, but yeah, I'm really enjoying like seeing people go from that level. Obviously, like I said before, like it's highly influenced by the era and like the 90s and the 80s and whatnot, but you know, I like it. And with that being said, I will definitely be experimenting with a lot of color this season, especially for the summer, like bright colors like these, you know, like it's just nice and refreshing. I genuinely want to push myself into trying like things that I would normally not do on an everyday basis or like before. So I'm just trying to push myself and just to create more and do looks that I would normally not wear or try out things that I would normally not do. You know, just be open-minded about this whole vibe. Guys, I said I'm not gonna bore you guys and I'm just going on and on and on. Okay, so making sure that the color is, guys, how amazing is the color payoff? Like, yeah. Which is a personal pig I don't think I'll ever find a brush that is as amazing as the MAC 224. I've searched and I've looked and I have not found it. I'm just in love with the brush. You know, so I try my best to try and like obviously look for products that does work for me and support all those other brands out there. But at the end of the day, it's about finding what works for me best and what I enjoy using. And forever be a MAC girl. I love MAC stuff. However though, I'm still like looking at Urban Decay for like their palettes. Everyone loves Urban Decay for their palettes. I do too. And you know, I'm looking at purchasing more color. But the one brand that I feel has been doing really great with color, especially in eyeshadows, because I'm a color person, I go for color. Anything that is artistic and over there and out there is my type of brand. You know, anything that allows me to be the creative that I am and creating just like different things and whatnot, I go for that. So I'm really eager to see what Inlot is up to. Like with the JLo collection, it was great, it was cute, but I still feel like every other brand out there, they still cater for people who are more into beauty and not artistry. So I'm still looking for a brand that will offer me the product, you know, that will offer me an opportunity to be creative with their product and play around and, you know, and create all these nice things with, like, you know, because I'm not a beauty person. I would rather do something that is very fun, something different. Color, I'm highly inspired by color, you know, so I'm still looking for a brand that will give me that, and I'm not finding it, and I'm just like MAC, and I'm sticking to MAC because of that. But I really do enjoy Inglot's color. I have never tried Black Up, and I heard they have like really amazing eyeshadows, which I really want to try, but obviously it's quite pricey. So I'm just, you know, for brands that are, you know, are about the color and the creativity of makeup and the artistry of makeup. And right now, everything has been about beauty and skin and nudes. I'm over that. So, okay, so moving along, I'm going to go in with my Morphe palette, and I'm going to use this purple over here just to add some definition to my eye and a little bit of like a smoked out effect. I'm not done with the pink, I'm still gonna go in with that as well. So I'm just gonna place this over here and just blend it out. So yeah guys, that is that. Those are my views about this whole makeup art, makeup industry, and you know, all these amazing products that are being launched. I'm unable to find something that is catering for me as an artist, you know. And that's why I would go back to MAC, and I would go back to Craig Vallon. Even though I'm not like a special effects makeup artist, I still think they still give me like the paints that I use, because I use a lot of face paints. I still think they do cater for me in that sense. But I'm looking for a brand that is very, very, very artistic. I can't stress that enough, and I'm just not finding it, and I'm just not finding myself with all these brands. So until they decide to do one, or until they decide to cater for us creatives a little bit more, girl, I'll be waiting. Okay, so I'm just blending this in a little bit more and just pulling it inwards. This is the same look I wore for my birthday, or on my birthday. So a lot of people were like, "Siddy, do a look like this so I'm deciding to go ahead and do it. And please watch and like. Also, about the makeup artists that are out there busy charging people. Oh, you know what? I'm not trying to be shady and I'm not trying to, you know, come for anyone or any makeup artist out there. That's not what I'm doing. Or, listen, it's not even about the makeup artist right now, it's about the client. You know, I've been getting a lot of clients, and I've been complaining about this for a long time. I've been asking people how much they would charge for a look like this. So right now I contoured, I did my brows, I did everything, I'm doing my eye, which is like all these colors, and I'm baking, and which is generally a look that would take me an hour and a half to do on someone else's face, right? And this is the look that most of former trick dancers and all these events, this is what people want. You know, it's a face beat, and it's what people like, and it's what people ask for, and I'm happy to do it. I am not happy to do it at a very small rate. A, because I know I'm a relatively great makeup artist based on the experience and whatnot that I've got. B, I studied for this. I'm not like a self-taught makeup artist, you know, so. And I work a lot with people. I'm a makeup artist for people. I don't do makeup on myself only. I also do like all that, those things. And that's why I studied, as me creating a business out of what I do, right? So, with that being said, I feel like most people or most clients don't appreciate a great makeup artist. I don't know, you know, people want the best face out there. People want to look their best, but people are not ready to pay for the best. And it baffles me. Like, I don't understand why that is. I'm struggling to understand why people won't pay, or why people would say my rates are expensive. So I genuinely charge for a face like this, for an event, I charge 900 rand, which to me is fair. And it's quite, for my experience and for what I'm offering you, and I know for sure that you're gonna look beautiful. That I'm not even gonna front with you. I know you're gonna look the best and amazing, and I'm gonna do a really great job. And I give you the opportunity to tell me if you don't like something that I've done on your face, which is genuinely what any makeup artist is doing. But guys, I'm failing to understand why people won't pay 900 rand for a face and would rather go to someone who would charge them 300 rand for, do you know what I mean? Yeah, so that is my feeling about all, like, the pricing of the makeup, and, you know, so I would really, really love for you guys to tell me and suggest, like, what you would pay for a makeup application, or like a full face of makeup. So let a girl know. Alright, so I've done the top of my eye, or my crease, with the purple, and I'm going to continue on the lower lash line with the same purple.
just continuing with the smoke. And then I'm gonna take the same eyeshadow, the pink one, and just sweep it underneath my eye. Okay, so right now I'm gonna go in with my Urban Decay Electric palette, which is like a really cute, it's a really cute colorful palette, which I'm also enjoying. I actually got it a while back, but I haven't really experimented with it. Like I said, this whole trend is actually pushing me to play with makeup and, you know, colors that I haven't played with before, so I'm quite excited to try out. So I'm gonna go in with this palette, and right now I'm gonna use this pink over here, which is called Jilted. Very nice shimmery pink. It has a little bit of, I think, blue purple inside, which is very, very, very beautiful. It creates like a very beautiful sheen. Okay, and then I'm gonna spray my little brush with my Fix Plus spray just for more color payoff. Spray it like that. Place this in the inner corners of the eye. The application of this eyeshadow is very amazing. It's very soft, you know, it's a very beautiful sheen. Like, it doesn't, it's not hard to put on the eye. Gorgeous, guys. Okay. I'm gonna do the same on the other eye. Oh, love. Okay. So for my final touches, I'm gonna pop in some glitter, and I'm using 3D Lavender from MAC. I'm not gonna do a hectic glitter application. I'm just gonna do enough so that it gives me like a nice reflection. Okay, again, I'm gonna spray my brush with Fix Plus. This thing just smells amazing. Dip it into the glitter. Just a little, you don't want to do a lot. And then I'm just gonna place it just here. And it's done very roughly, not. Oh,
guys, I'm so obsessed.
Okay, so moving along, I'm going to apply my mascara, which is the Extended Play, which is one of my favorite mascaras ever, because I just love how it extends my lashes. And this is from MAC. I'm just gonna wiggle that into my lashes. Just make sure that it's nice and chunky. Okay, and then I'm gonna do my lower lashes. Okay guys, so this is the completed makeup look. I have finished my makeup off camera because like I said, today was all about the eye. And yeah, so I hope you guys really enjoyed that video. Give it a thumbs up if you like it. Comment all your suggestions below, thinking about what we spoke about or what I touched on or our little chit-chat. Yeah, so subscribe if you haven't subscribed to my channel, just so you can get the latest videos from me. Otherwise, this is it from me. I hope you guys have a lovely, lovely, lovely day further. And I will see you guys soon. Bye. For like I give me love. Oh. Now you the catch in my shot. Oh. For your sake, I go touch you. Yeah. We go drive around you for my Porsche. Baby pana, they say he like you all I get you all like. Baby pana, anywhere that you go I go follow you the go. Baby pana, they say he like cassava. I get you big cassava. Baby pana, my love for you, you never die, you never die. If I ever, oh baby.